feels like a good fish. Like a nice speck coming to the boat. Hello again, folks. Welcome to another edition of Between the Banks. I'm Bob Goose. Oh, small red. Get on over here, boy. Alright. Fall, wintertime fishing. In the South Texaco field. Stay tuned. It's going to be another rock and talk of edition of Between the Banks. Stick with us.
Between the Banks is brought to you by Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Louisiana.
My name is Janet Chasson, and I'm a director of nurses at Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Louisiana. And I lead a team of nurses who help our members to manage their health care. A lot of times people are surprised to know that we have nurses that can help them. We don't take the place of their doctor. We help the members in between doctor's appointments. We live by the mission of improving the health and lives of Louisianans. We really do.
Up and down the bayou. That's how we tell you to get from one place to the other. It's a little different, but so are we in Louisiana's Cajun Bayou. And once you get here, you'll understand why our Cajun runs a little deeper. Find a piece of our story on swamp tours, fishing boats, at festivals, attractions, and restaurants. Visit lacajunbayou.com to plan your trip today. Louisiana's Cajun Bayou. Rich, natural, unapologetically Cajun. Just south of New Orleans, where Cajun runs deep.
Alright, so that fish hit Cajun free swimming. Just free swimming right along all the oysters, which the South Texaco field is famous for. I'm at my best spot. Dee's Canal, right at the beginning of Dee's Pond, throwing a Cajun free swimming over the oysters. And it looks like the reds are going to be on here. So don't forget, redfish, you can have five. They got to be 16 inches. One of your five can be over 27. That's per day. So let's check it out on the scale right here. Or on the measuring board, I should say. 15 inches. Pinching the tail. Goes back in the water. Stay tuned. I'm going to show you how I'm rigged. All right, folks. So this is how I'm rigged. I've got a 7-foot medium action rod. Medium action covers everything. Carolina rigging, cork rigging, free swimming, all of that. It lures. That's why I use a medium action 7-foot rod. Now I got wind blowing today. I got a 5 to 10 knot wind out of the east that's picking up to 20. I'm sure you can hear the wind on the microphone. Now, so at the end of the line, I'm using spinning gear. At the end of the line, 12-pound test, I have a black crane swivel. That's a number 7. Okay, then I have my shock leader, 25-pound test, triple fish camo line. Green, red. Instead of using fluorocarbon, it's called camo line because it's got multi-colors, red, and it's low vis, fish can't see it. Then at the end of the line, the shock leader, I've got a number 4 kale hook. I don't use a number 1 during the 1-aught like I normally would do during the summertime at the islands. I go down to a number 4 black hook. Okay, and then I'm just letting the big goo-goo minnow, I know you can see how big that minnow is. I'm just letting that big goo-goo minnow swim right above all the oysters and stuff. And that's what's happening. I'm just casting it out. I've got nervous water. I got trench right here at the fishing spot that the fish travel in. I'm just casting it out, hits the water, and I'm just letting it swim. And if conditions really get tough on me where I'm not getting hit, I'm going to take it and put it in the gunwale on the side of the boat here and just let the rod sit there, watch the tip, and when a fish hits it, it bows up, believe me, and they usually hit it hard. Reds and specks on top of the oyster beds in the South Texaco field. That's what I'm doing, and I'm using a host of different baits. I'm fishing with multiple lines. I'm putting them in the holder. I got a Carolina rig out in the middle of the canal in case any big reds or specks or white trout start hitting out there. Just pulled up at the spot. We'll see what we can catch. Stay tuned. Broke the surface when I set the hook on him. Oh yeah, speck of fur. Got him. And I believe he's gonna keep it. Boy, I'm gonna tell you, there's nothing but big time fun when you free swim big cockahoes. I mean fun. And when you can get on top of all these irregular features, these oyster beds, and just let that minnow swim, put it in a holder, relax, especially during cold fall and winter time. Now he's croaking, so I know it's a male. And I've got tide switching from falling to incoming now. We had a cold front come through, blew all the water out. Now the high pressure's moving to the east of us. Barometric pressure is falling, getting a little cloudy, bad weather coming. So conditions are perfect. And we're filming this on new moon in December. In fact, when this airs, it'll be close to Christmas. So on behalf of Turtle, me, Hayden, the gang at Between the Banks, the two Jamies, LCN and Etel Jamie, Merry Christmas from all of us to y'all. So specs got to be 12 inches and you can have 25. So let's check it out and see how long it is. I'm hoping that it measures, because when Turtle is with me and she's filming, when I bring specs in, I'll fillet these, put them on a steak plate, she'll grill them for me, and they're just so good. 13 inches in the box he goes. I'm getting back out there. I know I told you some alternate baits, but I'm going to show you that before I end the show. So there's speckled trout going in the box. Stay tuned. Feels like I got a oyster reeling in. I'll be able to show you. Oh no, it's a flounder. He just pulled back on me. Oh, he's not that big, but he's keeping. All right, so that's a speck, a red, and now a flounder. Flounder, you can have 10 per person per day. And there's no size limit on them. You can take the small ones or the big ones, it doesn't matter. There's no length limit. So 10 of these you can put in the box. Great for stuffing with crabs, especially the smaller ones like this. You can stuff them with crab meat, remove the backbone and everything out, and it really makes for some good eat. So, Mr. Flounder, still hitting that free swimming cockahoe on the end of a shock leader with that number 4 cale hook. Big menace. Always catch the fish. Stay tuned. if you don't like fishing with live bait, there's a bunch of options. Especially if it starts getting cloudy, like it is right now. So what do I fish with when it's cloudy?
That's what I fish with.
A she-dog. There you go. A lot of people say to me, Bob, I don't ever fish with live bait. I like to fish with artificial bait. And believe it or not, I fish with artificial bait too. It really dictates, what really dictates what kind of bait I'm going to use is what kind of conditions I've got. So when you work in baits over about a foot above a foot or so above the oyster beds. All right, now you stay there, buddy. No, don't get the hook in here. Okay, so I'll throw a she-dog. I'll tie it directly to the line. And then I'll also make sure that I keep checking the end of the line here, because a lot of times that hook will hook that, declamate that line. So that's one artificial bait. Then, here's a couple of other baits that I'm going to throw on top of those oysters. Just a straight H&H spinner with a Colorado-style blade. If there's grass, I'm going to switch that blade to a willow leaf. And then, of course, that's a H&H queen tuxedo cockahoe on a white jig head and a spade head, because I'm going to crank this through the water. I don't want a round head or any other style jig head. I want a pointed spade head so it comes through the water real easy. And all I do is crank that right above the oysters. Now, when you're using spinners, when you're cranking, you got to feel that blade spinning. And if you don't feel the blade spinning, then you don't have the right action. You may have too thick a line to get the proper action. But you want to feel that blade spinning, because what happens is as it comes through the water, that's what it does. And it gives the bait action, real important. Now, inline spinner. Of course, this is a straight jacket baboon. It's weedless. It's an inline spinner. Everything's in one line. I can throw that out and crank it, and I can put whatever favorite plastic I want on the line. Now, one other bait that I'm going to show you, and I know I'm taking a lot of time with this, but it's important. Let me just flip the net so that speck doesn't run away. I'll run to the back to the leaning post, and I'll grab this line for it. Okay, so you're going to die when I show you this. This is probably one of my favorite topwater lures that I can throw. And I can throw it whether it's cloudy or not. It just clump, clump, clump like you would for bass. But what I do is I take the skirt off of it and I put a DOA shrimp or any one of my favorite shrimp on it. And I'll crank that up on the surface. If the sun is shining, I'll crank it just below the surface. So there's all artificial lures that you can catch. Now again, we're on new moon. So when you fish new moon, you got a nice range in tide. It's a dark moon and it gives you the edge. Even though it's winter time or it's cold, you can come out here and catch a nice mess of assorted fish. Specks, flounder, redfish, like we're doing. Stay tuned. That's for all you artificial guys. But again, I like to throw it too. So try those baits on your, if you're artificial and you don't want to fish live bait. Feels like a red. just free swimming that big old cockhole. Yep, looks like a red. I'll tell you what, if it's a speck, it's a nice one. Redfish. Come on out there, boy. Oh, yeah. Keeper. Keeper. There you go. A nice redfish. Perfect grilling size. Redfish are all over the place. I mean, you come to Leeville and you're looking for redfish, you're gonna nail them. They're everywhere, you know. If the wind's blowing out of the east, fish the west. If they're blowing out the west, fish the east. Let me grab the pliers. I'm gonna take this fish off. Stay tuned. Nice red. Grab the fucking grill. My hands are so cold. You know, I mean, just so cold. That small hook during the winter time, I go down to that number 4 KO hook instead of that 1-0, and it really works a lot better. There you go. All right, let's check him out. Tail's all lit up. So you know they're feeding. And all you gotta do is find a place with oysters. That's what I like to fish. I like to fish on top of oysters. About a 19-inch red. And the South Texaco field is full of oyster beds. I mean, just a wonderful place to fish. I read all these comments about it can't fish, everything's posted, you know, all that. The South Texaco field is not posted. You can come in here and you can fish the oyster beds, you can float the ponds, you can have a field day. That's why you see so many kayakers back here. And it's a big section. I'm gonna show that to you on the map. Okay, there's a red for the box. In the box he goes, stay tuned. Red. Take him, drop line. Nice. Another nice one. I'm telling you, you come back in the South Texaco field and there's nothing but redfish, speckled trout, flounder. We pulled up to film this show and we dropped anchor. We haven't dropped the trolling motor other than to ease up to the spot. That's it. Like I say, we're fishing this at the end of New Moon week in December. We're taping this on the 13th. And the weather's perfect. We got New Moon tide. We're fishing on the downside of the high pressure. We had a big front blow through, nice and cold. I always keep bringing that pliers over there. Oh, got it out. See, just a short shock leader with a big cockahoe on the end of a number 4 kale hook with a split shot, maybe a 16th of an ounce at the heaviest on that swivel so you don't get kinks in your line. Black crane swivel. And it just really works. You take it, folks, and you throw it out on top of the oyster beds and just let that cockahoe swim. That weight's just enough to slow him down. and cast it out into nervous water. That's all nervous water from the current hitting those oyster beds and rolling over all throughout that big pond. And you can see the big slick. And then to the left where we're panning the bank there, you can see the oysters sticking out right there too. You just gotta be careful if you got a fiberglass boat. But I'm gonna show you on the map feature just how to come into this area. And you can always catch these in the wintertime, no matter what the weather's doing. You can come in here and catch reds all the time. And some big specks too, but you need the high tide. And with the heavy north winds blowing water out during the wintertime, mostly redfish. But when you get that incoming tide, the specks will turn on big time. Great place to fish, South Texaco Field. I'm gonna put this in the box. We'll take a break. Go check out the Marina Minute. All the fine businessmen that make your fishing trip to Leeville complete. Renovations, Gagoos, Griffins, Boudreaux's Waterfront Motel, fixing up the place, new management. You gotta come back if you're an old customer and check them out. Here's the Marina Minute. I'm going to follow it with the map, show you just where this area is.
Boudreaux's Waterfront Motel. Dock your boat at the end of the pier right under your room. Set up your grill. Got your own fish cleaning station. Your own ramp. And for big groups, enjoy the sunset at the Boudreaux House. Boudreaux's in Leeville.
Griffin's Marina and Ice has bag, block, and blown ice for whatever size boat. Both dockside and roadside ethanol-free fuel, convenience store, breakfast, crispy chicken, all conveniently located in downtown Leeville.
Renovations is your complete marine center for sales, parts, and service. Pathfinder, War Eagle boats, Minn Kota motor guide trolling motors, power pole and Minn Kota anchoring systems, pumps, trailer parts. Renovations will keep you on the water. All right, folks, here's the map feature. Now, brought to you by the good folks at Lowrance. Now, I know I'm anchored in shallow water here. I've got the back of the boat in about a foot and a half, and I got the front of the boat up in about 6-8 inches of water. Okay, I'm right on the edge of the oyster beds. But I wanted to start wide here so I can show you the South Texaco Field. Here's Boudreaux's. Came out to Boudreaux's Canal. There's the Southwest Canal. Came to Bayou Lafourche. Came down to just past the jackups and entered the South Texaco Field. Now I'm going to show you how to get into the field, but I wanted to show you how big this place is. This is the Southwest Canal all the way to Little Lake. Then go all the way down to Bay Hackberry, Hackberry Bay. Then come all the way across to Bayou Lafourche. All of this section of area is called the South Texaco Field. And you can see in the old days just how many canals come through here. Now a lot of the marsh has been worn down by storms and stuff through the years. But you can see all the canals in here. And everywhere you see this kind of orangish green color, that's all oysters. That's all oyster beds that are located here. Here's a huge one right off the Southwest Canal. Then, of course, all the ponds that are in here. Now, I'm going to zoom in so I can show you exactly how to enter the South Texaco Field. A lot of people don't fish here because they're afraid of the oysters and not being able to learn how to navigate in here. But if you put your trolling motor down and troll around, keep your foot full handy, it's not that hard to do. What I like to do is come in past the jackups. I enter the South Texaco Field and I come all the way around to Redfish Point number 2. That's Redfish Point number 1. You can see all my marks where I've caught fish here before. Here's the island of Redfish Point 2. When you come by Redfish Point 2, you got to split the canal.
The canal from the middle towards this bank is nothing but mud flat and oysters. It's a big shallow flat. So if you come in too close to this point, you're gonna run aground. So you gotta stay wide. I'll even zoom in a little more so you can see. See how when I come in to by Redfish Point 2, see how close I get to that bank? Not on top of it, but well to the right side. Then I hug the canal, come in, and then I'm gonna turn by the little shortcut through that has the cribbing. And I pass just to the left of the cribbing, the old wellhead, and fall into D's canal. This canal is deep. Zoom back out a little bit and show you where this canal will take you. This canal goes all the way down, make a right turn, and there's the entrance to Bay Hackberry. Real deep here, great bull red fishing right here at that pass. But that's the way to come into the South Texaco field. Great fishing place, and there's nobody gonna run you out. And look at all these deep canals that are in here. So a lot of structure, irregular features, and oyster beds. Okay, so there's the map feature. Now let's get the coordinates right for the point where I'm fishing D's Pond. North 29, 14, 154. West 90, 13, 149. That's D's Point at D's Pond, the pond where I'm fishing at right here where the boat's located. This huge, big, oyster-laden pond, D's Pond. There's the map brought to you by the folks at Lawrence.
Folks, there you have another edition of Between the Banks. A quick limit of redfish, two specks, a flounder from one anchored position. There you go, another redfish. Right here from the same spot. Never left. You come to the South Texaco field during the winter time when it gets cold and you will have a blast. And when the tide switches from incoming, from outgoing to incoming, you can fish the middle of the canal, catch specks and white trout. It's just a really awesome place to fish the South Texaco field. Don't forget, want to see past editions of Between the Banks? Check us out on YouTube. Bob Goose, keyword, go to my YouTube channel and you can see the last 100 episodes of Between the Banks. Check it out. Also, our television cable companies, all the fine sponsors that bring Between the Banks. And finally, on behalf of the staff at Between the Banks, Merry Christmas and Happy New Year.